Welcome everyone to Defender for Cloud in the Field. We had such an amazing Ignite, so many news, and of course we're gonna follow up on each topic that we announced of the new capabilities at Ignite. And in today's episode we are going to talk about Defender for DevOps, which is a new plan that we announced at Ignite. So before we start, just a quick reminder: if you are not a subscriber for the Microsoft Security Channel, make sure to click subscribe. Hit the bell to receive notifications when we upload new episodes, and we're gonna have a lot of episodes coming up. And the AKA link to go to the playlist of Defender for Cloud in the Field is right below. Make sure to subscribe. All right, so with that, Defender for DevOps. And to talk about this new plan, I have here with me my friend Sukhandeep Singh from our engineering team. Sukhandeep, thank you very much for being here today.
Hi, Yuri. Thank you for having me.
All right, Sukhandeep. Amazing news at Ignite. I think that a lot of people were really looking forward to have coverage in the coding perspective. So give us an overview about Defender for DevOps solution and why customers should start thinking about security as they shift left.
Yeah, so Defender for DevOps is the shift left platform within the Microsoft Defender for Cloud suite. It integrates your source code management systems to empower security teams to protect their resources from code to cloud. Currently, Defender for Cloud is very focused on the runtime assets. So this is more enabling a view into the DevOps world and getting an end-to-end view into what the customer sees for their security.
Awesome. That's really a missing piece in Defender for Cloud that we are now fulfilling with Defender for DevOps. So what are the current integrations that we have in Defender for DevOps?
So as of Ignite, the last announcement that we made, we currently have integrations for GitHub and Azure DevOps platforms. So you can create connectors within Microsoft Defender for Cloud that allow you visibility into your security state for both these platforms.
Outstanding. Now let's go deep a little bit on the GitHub, right, connector, because we have a connector available for you to connect with your GitHub repository. So what are the prerequisites to configure this connector, and do I have to have GitHub Advanced Security to create this connector?
Yeah, so at this point of time, the GitHub Connect use is a little nuanced. If you have a private repo, you need to have GitHub Advanced Security. It is a requirement. However, if you have public repos or if you are looking for just dependency scanning results, then you can do without GitHub Advanced Security.
Okay, but this is to configure or to have the additional functionalities? I mean, the question is more like, if I just want to configure, can I even configure with my, you know, free version of GitHub just to connect?
Yes, you can connect and configure. However, for results to flow in into MDC as of today, you would need GitHub Advanced Security if you're a private repo. And because GitHub Advanced Security is available for free as part of a public repo, so you already have it available, so it would work right off the box.
Got it. Okay, cool. So after I configure GitHub Connector, what should I really expect in my Defender for Cloud dashboard?
Yeah, so the connector is essentially a communication pipe that we are setting between MDC and the customer's DevOps environment. What it is allowing us to do is to listen and monitor for various security events within their repos, within their DevOps environment. And we would have a few different kind of recommendations that it will start showing up. So if we find a repo for which we do not hear any security issues, then you would get recommendations that would say, hey, we do not see any, you don't have secret scanning enabled or code scanning enabled for these repos. Please go enable it within your GitHub world so that you can start seeing results. And if GitHub Advanced Security is already enabled or the secret scanning and code scanning are already enabled, in that case, you would start seeing recommendations that will be a summary of results across all your repos and accounts within GitHub that you onboarded, and you would be able to see results like, these are all the repos with secrets. Here are all the secrets that we found that you can follow up with your developers and get them to fix. Additionally, there's also a DevOps security view, which gives you an inventory of all your repos that we are seeing and a summary view of various code scanning, secret scanning results that you see, so that you have an executive dashboard to give a one-stop shop view of where your DevOps security looks like.
That's awesome. That's pretty cool. In this public preview that we released at Ignite, do we have also any protection for infrastructure as a code?
Yes. Infrastructure as code is a key area for cloud security, especially building templates within code and then deploying code directly to cloud. So we have a couple of Defender for DevOps clients, one for GitHub, one for Azure DevOps, that the customers can use to scan their ARM, Terraform, and Bison templates for security gaps. And then the recommendations would flow. Of course, for GitHub side, the GAS, GitHub Advanced Security requirements still holds. The customers can configure these clients, called as Microsoft Security DevOps GitHub Action within GitHub and Microsoft Security DevOps Azure DevOps extension within Azure DevOps, and run these scanners within their workflows, within their pipelines in GitHub and ADO, and get results that they can then fix within their build environments.
Okay. And what are the capabilities that we are bringing to Azure DevOps, since we are talking about Azure DevOps as well?
Great segue there. So Azure DevOps is similar to GitHub, where customers can create a connector, start looking at their Azure DevOps world. As of Ignite, you can run the DFD client, the Microsoft Security DevOps extension, to do infrastructure as code, secret, code security, and container scanning in their build pipelines. However, when you're looking for results within the DevOps blade and within the MDC recommendations, you would only get recommendations for secrets. We are looking to add the others as we move forward in the coming months.
Okay, excellent.
And one last thing, sorry.
No problem.
We are also adding a capability called as pull request annotations within the Azure DevOps world today that is available at Ignite. In that, you can enable pull request annotations within your build pipelines so that your developers can get the secrets recommendations when they commit code to their main branches and fix it within their DevOps regular world.
Outstanding. This is actually great. And let's take a look how this whole thing works on your demonstration. So let's switch to the demo.
Cool. So within Microsoft Defender for Cloud, within environment settings, you can enable connectors for GitHub and Azure DevOps. So for this demo, I'll click the GitHub one. So you click the GitHub environment, select demo name, plan name for this, say demo test. You can specify a resource group, select the region where you want it to be deployed. You select plans. There's a default plan that has the basic features, and then there's a premium paid plan that would be free and only charged post GA. This would include all the paid features. Then you go on to authorize connection, where you basically authorize Defender for DevOps to listen to your different repos and environments. So at that point of time, it goes to GitHub, and I had actually done that earlier, so it was quick. And then you're installing the app. So here it is showing me all the different accounts or organizations within GitHub that I can install this on. So I select Contoso DFD, and the 2FA works perfectly. Okay. So once you authenticate, it essentially allows you to select all the different repos. So you have two options here. You can select all repositories that you own within that account, or you can do only select and check the specific repositories within that account that you want to add to your pipeline. So for our simplicity, we would add all repositories and save, and this would take us back. So now when you go review and create, you have a connector that is set up that is able to look into that Contoso DFD account, and it has access to all those repos. Now what this does is, once this connector is created, you would see something like this here: Contoso Hotels, Contoso Hotels ADO. These are respective account connectors for each environment. And when these environments are created, we will start listening to the security events within your Azure DevOps and GitHub environments, and you would start seeing recommendations like these. So within recommendations, there's the enable enhanced security features. In that, you would see recommendations like GitHub repositories should have code scanning enabled, dependabot scanning enabled, secret scanning enabled. And if you click on these, it gives you guidance on how to enable that. Essentially, for GitHub's case, it is mostly talking about saying you need to go click on a few buttons to enable GitHub advanced security and enable secret scanning specifically in that repo for you. So once these recommendations are enabled and results start flowing in, you would start seeing the second set of recommendations, which is like this, where it will say code repositories have code scanning findings that need to be resolved. Similarly for secret, dependency, and infrastructure as code. So if you click on this infrastructure as code scanning findings, it'll give you details in terms of affected resources, where it'll call out the repos where we are finding issues. It'll also give you the details of all the issues we found. So if I select this one, on the right side of the pane, you would see in the branch main, there's a path called IAC Azure ARM, where you have this file Azure deploy.json. On line 84 of that, we found an issue that the template analyzer specifies as TA0019, and there's a URL that actually takes you to the exact repo, exact location where this issue is found, so you can even send it to your developer to get them to fix it. And so this is where you get all the recommendations and results for each type of scanning. Now, in addition to this, we also have a DevOps security overall view, where you would start seeing the different repos. So you have both your GitHub repos here and Azure DevOps repos, and it starts telling you whether you have exposed secrets or none, whether you have open source vulnerabilities on it, whether you have code scanning vulnerabilities. So the results, there will be a summary view here. So this is your executive dashboard where you can see overall results. And additionally, the last thing here that you can do is, for Azure DevOps repos, you can go in there and select a repo, say like DFD demo here, and click on configure up top, and it allows you to enable pull request annotations. So you can select off and on here to enable the feature. Currently, it allows you to annotate for secret scanning results. So you would enable and save this. And once this is saved, it'll start annotating any secret scanning results that are found within your pull request annotations. To show you an example of that, so this is a standard pull request that ran. So in that, there were secret scanning results that were found, and you can basically go in here and, just like a developer would see that, hey, in locals.settings.json, we found a secret in there that you need to fix. So this is just like a developer would have a peer review their pull request and provide comments in there. Similarly, the tool would annotate so that the developer will review the comments, fix it, or take care of it. And that will be part of their regular developer experience, and nothing out of the way that they need to do to fix issues that are security issues, ensuring that the secrets never make it to production.
Okay, that's pretty cool.
Yep, that is the extent of our MDC side of the demo. And then there's a couple of additional parts where, like, for scanning to be enabled within GitHub, we have a DFD client called Microsoft Security DevOps Action that customers can use to enable scanning within their workflows. We have explicit instructions on how to enable to edit your workflow. It allows you to run specific tools for container, IAC scanning, so on and so forth. I won't go into details on how to run that. A typical workflow, you just need to add these comments in there and run. And similarly, you have a DevOps extension that allows you to do the same in the Azure DevOps world.
That's great, Scott. Thank you very much for the demo. We are definitely expanding Defender for Cloud with Defender for DevOps. Now we are looking at your repositories, your code, giving recommendations for hardening, and also giving integrating with GitHub Advanced Security to give all other capabilities. Great demonstration. Very excited about this public preview. Make sure to access our labs. I'm gonna put the hyperlink below. Make sure to access our labs. We have two new modules in the labs dedicated to Defender for DevOps that you can try out. One module is covers the Azure ADO connector. The other module cover the GitHub connector. So you can experience this with a hands-on activity. Sukhan, thank you very much again for your time. I truly appreciate it.
Thanks, Yuri. It was very exciting to first announce this as Ignite and now show this demo to the customers. Very excited on how this will be able to help our security customers out there.
Absolutely. Thank you very much. All right, everyone. This is a wrap. Stay tuned. Subscribe. We have a lot of new episodes coming up where we're going to dive deep into each topic that we announce at Ignite. So stay tuned for more.